morning. It is the middle of winter. I walk into work. This is a beautiful coat my own that used to belong to my best friend's mum who passed away. So it makes me feel good just wearing it, thinking about her. Okay, today we're going to talk about how people are nuts. Not meaning to be rude, but I just have this theory that 2% of people are a bit nuts, whether that's your investors, because I've had that. I've had a couple of people, most of my investors have been absolutely fantastic people to work with, and I've enjoyed pretty much every minute. I've enjoyed the relationships. I would definitely do it again. A couple of people, you know, you'd definitely be like, thank you, goodbye, good luck. It'd be okay if maybe our paths don't cross again. And tenants, again, most of my tenants are people that you'd be proud of. You know, you'd have interesting conversations with. And maybe 2%, no, thank you, goodbye. We've had our usual share of evictions. So let's talk about when one tenant assaults another and the police are called and the tenant's arrested. You're thinking men, aren't you? Nope, two ladies. We got a tenant who actually has always been a little bit frustrating. Pays her rent 7 days late, which is wholly rude. I mean, just rude, because in my opinion, because the contract is you pay on the first. And so we chase her every single month. I mean, it's boring. And there's been a few other little bits of behavior over the time. And there's been clearly an escalating war between them. Well, they're grown-ups. We don't get involved. You know, I have no interest in resolving petty complaints that are at the child level. I don't rent to children, I rent to adults. And if you guys can't manage your relationships within an adult context, we're binary. We either remove one person or remove both people from the situation. Because I'm not a referee. I'm a landlord, you're grown-ups. So basically Michael yesterday told me that what happened is one of the tenants had, and they've been kind of accusations of people being prostitutes and also, which they're not, by the way. Just silly stuff. And it'd been rising for the last couple of months. So yes, so one tenant, but silly stuff, you know, stuff like, guys, you're gonna have to sort that out between you. This is not a landlord affair. And so one tenant actually assaulted the other tenant yesterday. The police were called and the tenant was arrested. Now, do you notice? I mean, I'm not smiling because it's not a nice situation. I'm smiling because it's nuts. And I'm afraid I find comedy in the bizarre behavior that you would get so uptight about a piece of washing up that you'd actually physically assault another tenant. That's just nuts. So what are we going to do about it? Well, we talked to all tenants involved. There are 5 tenants. We looked at past behaviour, and the consideration was evict one, evict the other, or evict both. I was perfectly prepared for all 3 scenarios, but what we're doing this morning is we're evicting the one who was arrested. Now, it's going to take 2 months to evict them. Section 21. The thing I want you guys to notice is it's not a drama. I might make it a dramatic headline, just so you should click on the video, but I have no dramatic feelings about it at all, apart from, that's nuts, let's have another cup of tea. So any situation you have with tenants, obviously you have to make sure your paperwork is bang in order, because you can't evict if your paperwork isn't in order. But I don't get involved in their dramas. It's a binary decision. Do I rent to you or do I not? Do you rent from me or do you not? The rest is respectfully your life, and the rest is respectfully my life, and they don't massively need to intermingle. So if you're having tenant issues and you're finding yourself getting drawn in into he said, she said kind of malarkey, don't. It's not your arena. It's binary. You evict one, you evict the other, or you evict both. You don't need to be arguing about washing up. Anyway, have a good day.